And can you smell it, Ricky?
Smell what?
It's a smell of freshly evicted housemate. That's right, ladies and gentlemen, we can smell it. But unfortunately, we can't touch it for reasons beyond our control. Nicole will not be joining us in the Big Mouth studio.
But don't worry, because we're still going to be talking about Nicole. So let's have a look at her time in the house.
I'm not joking when I say my girlfriend is absolutely stunning.
I believe you.
She looks like she's like perfect, absolutely, like perfect.
I don't want to be known as Rex's girlfriend.
The thing is, though, how can she have so much confidence to act like such a bitch?
That was the first thing I said to you, and you still do your little sneaky little things. You're just greedy.
Shut up, greedy. Take that can of Coke, take everything, you spoiled little...
All Nicole does is criticise. She doesn't, like, give praise to anybody.
I'm not horrible.
To be honest, I really don't want to be here because people like
you... Thank God for that. Please leave. The door's there.
I will.
Okay then, so Zoe, what did you think of Nicole?
Not much.
Really?
No.
Why is that?
She just wasn't great. You know, she had a great opportunity to come into the house and to really have fun, and I think she just threw it away.
So if she was here right now, what would you ask her?
Well, I think I'd have to ask her something about Rex, because let's face it, that's the reason why she's in the house in the first place. I'd probably ask her, was she really in love with Rex or in love with his lifestyle?
Well, what do you love about a man? Zoe?
Wet humour, red shirts, black ties, long pointy stick mics.
That's what I'm talking about, girl. We'll talk later on. Cool!
Hello.
What would you ask Nicole if she was right here, right now?
I would ask her in a very severe tone to take Rex to the hairdresser.
Wow. Wait! Are you not a Mohican kind of man?
I don't understand what his hair is. I don't understand what it's doing at the moment. It's kind of... It's some kind of cone effect, isn't it? It's like...
What do you think of Nicole generally, though?
I felt that she was generally really rather despicable, actually. She's one of those kind of awful posh girls that remind you why it's horrible
to be
posh.
Do you not like a posh girl?
No, I'm not fond of a posh girl.
Fair enough. Ricky, what did the audience think?
Guys, what do you think of Nicole?
What about she thinks she's so high maintenance? What about her hair?
Her hair? What's wrong with her hair? She's got nicer, hasn't she?
Greasy. Nice. Could have been a bit better.
Greasy? Do you not like her hair?
No, she needs to straighten it or something.
How do we think Rex is going to cope without Nicole? What do you reckon?
Very well.
Say that again.
I think he'll be fine.
You think what?
I think Rex will be fine without her because he was better before she went in, and now she's gone, I think he'll be a lot better.
But hasn't she been such a big part of his life since she's been in there that he's going to feel a bit weird?
Yeah, but so he says, but, you know, they've been having arguments every time, you know, every 2 minutes, so I don't think you'll miss her that much.
OK, what's your name?
Sarah Jane.
Sarah Jane. So if Nicole was sitting over there, what would you ask her?
Oh...
Keep it clean.
Yeah, all right. No, I just want to know why she was such a cow to everybody in the house.
Okay, so why was Nicole such a cow to everyone in the house? What do we reckon?
She's just a little diva, isn't she? I mean, why isn't she sitting here right now? She's just been a diva.
Just relax.
She's been a diva.
You look like an angel. You've got some fire in you, girl. I like that. Some zest. All right. So what mistakes do you think Nicole made in the house? Why did she make mistakes? What did she make
to be out here now? She was just horrible to everybody. She spoke to everyone like a piece of shit. And
this is a family show. My mum's watching. Don't say stuff like that.
Is there anything nice to say about her?
Are we sad that the last couple in the house has now been separated? Are we sad about that?
No.
Why are you not sad?
Well, they've been separated.
Don't you like to see love in the Big Brother house?
Oh, no, yeah, I am sad. I do like to see love in the Big Brother house, definitely.
Yeah?
I am, yeah, definitely sad she's gone. They did.
No, they were just
lovely. Okay, does anyone here think Nicole was just a bit misunderstood?
Yes.
Anyone? Yes, anyone? Anyone, yes? Yes? No?
I think she let Rex being there get to her too much. She should have done her own thing, ignored that he was there, and just got on with it herself.
Okay. It must have been hard for her, though, don't you think?
Yeah. She knew all what's going on in the outside world, didn't she? And she must have... think all those, the paranoia in there, they all knew she knew. She had to keep that all to herself.
But she knew that before she went in there, right?
If your boyfriend was in there and then you got the chance to stroll in, no audition, you would have gone straight in. Yeah, why not? Yeah, but she was... That's the downfall of her. She was too arrogant.
Absolutely love her.
I think she's all right. I do.
You wanted to ask her out on a date when she got in there, didn't you?
I could tell.
All right, that's fair enough. All right, so over the last 3 weeks, we've watched Nicole sleep, argue with Rex, do tasks, argue with Rex, laugh a little bit, argue with Rex, generally cry and then argue with Rex.
So, we think we've got a pretty good idea of what makes Nicole tick, but now she's left Big Brother, a whole new world of opportunities has opened up for her. And here's what Melvin and I think she should do with her life.
All right, so first up, let's look at her future career. Zoe, what should Nicole be doing in the future?
I think she should just stay in the house.
Stay in the house?
Stay in the house, fix the hair.
Like a job? Just stay at home.
She's just going to be a housewife, isn't she, to Rex, really?
All right, fair enough. Paul, what job should she be doing?
I think she should go work for the Samaritans.
Samaritans?
she's a people person.
She should be depressing the whole nation.
All right, guys, what job should Nicole do?
Sewerage maintenance.
Oh, sorry.
Sewerage maintenance, because she can dish out the shit, but she can't take it.
All right, so we've talked about Nicole's skills. She's a straight talker and grounded, and most of all, she's fair, even-handed, balanced and mature. So we thought, High Court Judge! Look at that wig. Right, now we know that Nicole's found her perfect match with Rex, but what if we were to think the unthinkable and she was to split up with him? Who would be Nicole's perfect partner? Zoe!
Your worst enemy.
Paul, what do you think?
I think the devil himself.
Wow.
So, guys, what do we reckon? Who would be the best partner for ideal partner?
Harry Silver.
Say that again.
She would be the perfect partner because they both just love to live off everybody else's money.
Okay.
That is the simple point why they would make such good partners.
The simple
maybe
life.
Maybe she could be single and have a dog like Harry Silver.
Like a little chihuahua
or
something.
And in a handbag. Yeah.
I could see her doing that, actually.
All right. So, we thought about the perfect match. They're still ginger, successful, wealthy, controversial, and even a flashy dresser. We think Nicole's perfect partner will be Anne Robinson. Look at them together. They look so happy. Now, we know Nicole wants to be an actress, and with her star-like looks and charisma, Tinseltown could be calling. Zoe, what would be the perfect role for Nicole?
No roles. She shouldn't be on TV again.
A big fan of Nicole there. Paul, what do you think?
I think she should be in the remake of Mean Girls.
Mean Girls? That would be good. Or Cell Block H, I like that.
Okay, so what do you reckon? What would be the perfect role for Nicole?
The dumb blonde on Scary Movie.
What, the one that gets killed. Before even the title. Yeah. And stuff. That was cold, brother. That was cold. Anyone got another like suggestion?
Say that again.
Shrek.
But Shrek's kind of cuddly, he's kind of cute. That's quite nice if you really think about it.
Have you seen where he lives?
he lives in a swamp, but he's a nice guy.
Princess Fiona.
Oh, there you go.
Yeah.
Perfect Princess Fiona.
That's very sweet, isn't it? All right, now, because Nicole's glamorous, sophisticated and cosmopolitan, we thought about it. What about Rex and the City?
Yeah, we like that. Yeah, Rex and the City!
All right, so that's our final Big Brothers Big Mouth. Thanks to our guest, Zoe Seven.
Come on, Zoe. Come on, give it up to Zoe. Come on.